Over here, I need to be able to see you. It's recording. My dog is running around the backyard with a bone. Magic! Okay, stay right there so I could see you. So, my book arrived. That's me in 2004. This is me in 2014, 10 years later. Should I look any different? Should we do the pose? I don't know. I don't remember what I was doing. It was a glamour shot. So I posted on Twitter that I was like, I can't wait for my book to come. And I'm kind of like hanging out by the door, but I guess I could leave because it'll still get delivered. And I went to go leave to go get my oil changed. And as I was driving down the street, there was a UPS guy. So I stopped him and I got my books. And it was a good thing that I got them from him because there's a lot of them and they're heavy. He was like groaning a little bit, or moaning a little bit because they were heavy. And he put them in my trunk, which was very nice of him. So here it is. That's me, Blair Allison. And look at that. So it's kind of, I don't know, it's, I don't know what to say. Like it's, don't know, it's like a fun feeling. It's exciting. It's also not the way that I saw it manifesting. Because as I shared with you guys in the other video, I never saw myself self-publishing. And Spirit says to me, well, it doesn't mean that it's not going to be published by a major publisher, but I needed to get it ready for this event that I'm doing in 6 days, July 16th. If you're in New Jersey, New York, come check out I'm speaking at an event. It's on my website. You can find all the details. It's a women's business networking conference I'm speaking at, and like I said, the details are on my website. I need to check on my dog. He's still there. Okay. So come out and hear me speak. I'm talking about doing business the spiritual way, and that's what Spirit was saying, like I needed to get my book ready for it, which it's a very interesting story, which I'm sure I'm going to be sharing that evening. But let's talk about this book. So this is the book. I'll just hold it here like Vanna White, like this, like that. Hello, hello. Like we'll do like little hand movements. It feels good to have my book. And I was looking through it, and I will tell you the text is a little bit big on this copy. I need to adjust that and make it a little bit smaller, but I was afraid that it was going to be too small when I was testing it through. But otherwise, it's very exciting just to like read through it. And I mean, this has been 10 years to the day. That I actually like, I mean, you can't really plan things out like that. Like this book, which again, I should still keep it in the screen, right? Like we'll be like little Vanna White here. This was a journey that I went on. I put up a website called maryblair.com in 2004, and it was for friends and family to find me the one, because I wanted to get married. It was a couple weeks before my 27th birthday. And all my friends were getting married, and all my friends were having kids. And see, now you know how old I am since it's 10 years later. Because I usually don't share my age anymore because I am living in the now and I am timeless. So I still celebrate my birthday, I just don't count my age anymore. But it's appropriate for this story. And this is the book of. So basically, the website was put up, and I put a deadline that I wanted to get engaged. By December 2004, which was in 6 months from the time I put up the website. And the countdown clock was a joke. It was just like some HTML I found online. And this is like before everyone's so website savvy and everything like that. Like the website that I made was very like kind of rinky-dink homemade. And I just wanted my parents to take me serious with my search that I didn't want to be looking for the one anymore. I wanted them to do it for me. And I really wanted them to understand that rather than just kind of laugh at how cute my website was, because they told me it was funny and cute, and I didn't want them to dismiss it because they usually dismiss me and my ideas. But I've healed those childhood wounds, so I could talk about it now. So the website ended up going viral, and everybody in the whole world was emailing me, and I was in the New York Times and MSNBC and CNN and Glamour Magazine and Inside Edition and all these different press publications that everyone was helping me find the one. And I was going on a lot of different dates with a lot of different men, and I was talking about my dating experience. And you see how 2 months into my search, the universe stepped in and started guiding me on how to find the one, the spiritual way. That's what I call the spiritual way to attract the one. That's what I teach now. It's one of the many things that I teach. And they stepped in, and the way that I started dating totally changed from the mainstream way that people go on dating sites, or they go to bars or clubs or singles events or asked to be matched up. I used to be all up in that scene. I used to call myself a dating coach, and I was good at what I did, but I don't teach anything like what I do now. My stuff got really this is the book where I started speaking to God and hearing God speak to me, and this is the book where I became the love guru. You see how I become the love guru before your eyes. You see how I am attracting soulmate after soulmate into my life by using these certain principles that I share in here. It's a story, so it's not like a how-to. It's you read my story and you learn about how I'm doing things. You learn how to do it yourself. And at the time when I was blogging about this journey, people who were reading the book, reading my blogs, were transforming just like I was transforming with love. And some of them even got married, found their soulmates and got married, and people were writing me. And so with everything that I write, it has healing energy in it. That's the way I teach. I teach through sharing my experience. It's one of the ways I teach, through sharing my experience, and you see on how I transform and the things that I learn, and then you apply that to your life and you transform too. That's how the healing work happens. And so I was guided to put this book out, and it has tons of dating and relationship advice. I have a whole section here. I answer like readers, people who were reading about my journey while this site was going on in 2004, 2005. People were sending in questions, and I was answering them, and there's a different take to it. Again, it's like it's on the spiritual side, but again, this was before I was like really spiritual, so you see that transformation with me. So you have a lot of dating like Q&A throughout, and then I have a whole special section in the back. Where is it? That is a whole separate area with dating Q&A. So there's And this is maybe 25 pages, 30 pages extra that you're getting. It's a hefty book. Woo, my God, Blair, damn. But the thing is that, so you're getting like a lot for your money. Like you're getting the story, you're getting the transformation, and you're getting like dating Q&A. You're getting like a lot of stuff. And then you never have to go back to dating the way that you used to, just like I haven't gone back since. And what was I going to say? So as I shared with you guys, I was guided to put this out myself 2 weeks ago. I had a rush, or 3 weeks ago, I had a rush to get it published for this event that I'm doing on the 16th. So this was a book that I like forgot about. It was there. It was like buried under my computer, and I knew one day it would get published and blast off, and I still know that that's going to happen because this was divinely guided, this book, and when you put out information that helps and heals so many people, God does his thing to get it into people's hands. Because personally, like me, I know how to attract the one now. I'll never go back to that old way of dating. I'll never feel powerless again looking for the one, or looking for a guy, or trying to get into a relationship. And that's the problem with a lot of people these days, is that they feel helpless in looking for the one, and they think that they have to turn to like a match.com, or they have to turn to a matchmaker, or they have to turn to friends, whereas this is teaching you how to harness your own power so that you can create and bring love into your life. And this means you're co-creating with God or spirit or the universe or nature, whatever you want to call source energy. So what I was going to say is, like, me personally, like, I'm not doing like a blitz campaign to promote this or what, because I don't know if I really care so much. I mean, I know how to do it myself. I know how to change things, and it's up to you. Like, if you want to learn how to date in an easier way, then you're going to seek out the resource. And this is like the dating Bible of like never having to go back to the old way. So, like I said, like my site went viral, like God made it viral, I know God will do his thing to be putting this book into the hands of people who need it, who really want it, and who want something to change in their life. So when I was guided to publish this book and put it out already, because my guides were yelling at me because I wasn't really listening for a couple days. It doesn't take long for me to really hear the guidance, but I was a little resistant to it. So that was going on for maybe 2 or 3 days that I heard them saying, publish the Mary Blair book, put it out there, get it ready for your event on the 16th. And I was like, really? I don't really want to do it. I don't want to self-publish. I'm not doing that. I'm like a snob. I don't want to self-publish. And they were like, yes, get it ready for the event. Get it ready, get it ready. So finally, I listened. And then as I was publishing it and getting it ready, they were releasing more information to me. And it ends up that over the years, because I have been writing for the last 10 years, I have been writing about my journey. And some of it I've been sharing, some of it I haven't. Some stuff I've been sharing little snippets. And it ends up that I've written a trilogy. This is so awesome. It's very interesting because I have been looking at the Hunger Games. That has been in my awareness lately. I made some videos about those books, and that's a trilogy. Then Spirit was guiding me to look at Harry Potter and then to look at Twilight books because I was like, oh, my God, I can't believe this book is 500 pages. Are you serious? People are going to read 500 pages? And it's really, it's a super easy and fun and light read. You can sit on the beach and just read it. And so it's very easy to read. It's not intense reading. It's funny and it's fun and it's enlightening and it's inspiring. And I mean, I was reading through it. It was making me laugh. I was like, oh my God, I can't believe I used to think like this. And that's the beauty of, that's one of the things I realized. I got to check on my dog. Okay, he's still there. That's one of the beauties that I realized of being able to self-publish it first is because when I was originally working with an agent for this book, because I've had several agents interested in it over the years that just wasn't right timing or a right connection or whatever. I'm a little picky about things. And also it wasn't right timing. So I was realizing when I was working with somebody originally, an agent, she wanted to edit a lot of stuff. And I realized that if I went the traditional route of publishing originally, that they would have edited this down to a 200-page book. And because I published this myself, I was able to do an unedited version of my story. And I did take out some parts because I wanted to get the main story in, and then some stuff I did take out, but I know that they would have taken a pen to it and X'd out a lot of the story. And one thing that I am dedicated to, and I've always been dedicated to, and always will, is that I feel like one of my gifts is being able to share the real, the raw deal of how someone goes about finding the one. A lot of times you hear people say, well, I met him or I met her and I just knew, and there were sparks in the air and it was happily ever after. That is total bullshit. It is never like that. I've worked with enough people to know how it goes, and there's little kinks to work out. There's little things here and there that they have to alter with their mind. Maybe there's some breakups in between. Maybe there's some parts that he liked her for a while and she didn't like him, or vice versa, and one had to convince the other or whatever. And with my stories, I always keep it real, and that's one thing that I'm really firm on and I'm really proud of, because I think it is important to be putting out real material about how this love thing goes. I gotta hurry up. I'm running out of battery on my computer. I didn't charge it up. Oh no. So that's what you're getting, like, is the real, the raw, the unedited story of how to attract the one and how to never go back to doing it again. You can get your copy on Amazon. You can get it on my website, loveguru.net. And what I was saying about the trilogy thing, I don't know if I have time to share it, but Spirit was revealing to me after I was, like, finishing this project and I had time to think about other things rather than, like, hurry up, you have deadline, is that I have written two other books. I have one, I have this one, Do You Know My Husband? I have my second book, which is about attracting your soulmate and turning that into a twin flame relationship and healing childhood wounds and having to do with clearing karma and becoming enlightened. That is my second book. I have a title for it. I'm not going to share it right now because it's not ready to be released. They just said, release this one. And then my third book in the trilogy has to do with my connection with my star family, which is, I've shared some videos about that, about the aliens. And I have the title for that book too, which is making me a little bit emotional, because Zeke, my star brother, told me that title of it when he first connected with me, like 2 days or 3 days or 4 days. It was right when we first met. He told me that I should start writing down our interactions because I was going to write a book about my connection with Star Family and how they helped me make my dreams come true. So I have a whole trilogy here happening over 10 years of my life that I'm sharing with you guys that I'm going to be releasing over the next year, 2 years, probably the next year or two years, that you're going to be able to read a love trilogy of the real deal of how someone finds the one, how someone is in a relationship with the one and heals childhood wounds having to do with that, because until you heal your childhood wounds, you are going to repeat the same patterns that you experienced in childhood, in your intimate relationship, as well as in your whole life. You're never going to be truly free, and you're not going to be free of karma. So that is the second book, and then the next one is about having to do with your dreams coming true, because that's what happens when you live in a state of, and you're going to see in that second book on how I become enlightened through that experience of having healed everything, and then you step into a place of total creation, that you're living in total freedom and creation of the life that you want to live, that you've been dreaming about. And that's the era that I'm stepping into now. That's the era that I have been stepping into. And it fills me with so much joy because these three books document on how much work I've gone through over the 10 years. And I'm just so proud of myself and so happy that I'm here. And I'm happy to share it with you guys. So once again, you guys can get this on my website, loveguru.net, and you can get it on Amazon. Just look up Do You Know My Husband? It's the unexpected journey of how the love guru found the one. That's it. Thank you for being on this journey with me. And my birthday is in 6 days. It's amazing on how this all happened during the same time span that this story was happening to me 10 years ago. I didn't plan it out this way. It just ended up that I was invited to speak, and then Spirit said to me, get that book out. And I realized while I was putting out that book, I said, oh my God, this, I'm creating this book at the same exact time that I did back 10 years ago when this website went viral. It's magical and fantastic. And when you work with Spirit, when you get in the flow and get in alignment, things happen like that, that you don't have to think about stuff. You're just following your heart and following your intuition. So thank you. Get the book. I will speak to you later. Bye.